in the bathroom, I am downtown. But he will not get away with it again. When the night comes in,
where did you come from?
I played by myself largely, kind of Hayden-esque-ish,
yeah,
for about 3 years all over town. Lots of railway shows and the arts club and
as a folky come rocker kind of?
Well, the thing was is I guess I always wrote songs in the pop rock vein, and a friend of mine just came up to me one day and said, you know, you don't write folk songs, Matt. Get a band. So I did.
Okay, so this is also your music room.
It is.
How can we tell this is your music room? First of all, there's a piano.
There's a piano.
And
the two guitars can give it away.
I don't see a lot of technology here.
Technology?
Well, like, you know, mixing boards. Nothing?
No. Mm. Actually, it's really bad because I remember one of the songs on the album, actually, Symbolistic, when I came up with the melody of it, I couldn't remember it. So I recorded it on my answering machine.
Ah.
So I would remember. So my answering machine is my recording device. I just record on my answering machine.
All kinds of bands are coming out, all got kinds of different sounds.
Mm-hmm.
And in terms of like labels, in terms of major label interests, mm-hmm. like, do you find that most of the labels are looking for one particular thing, or do they have any deviation in terms of what they're looking for?
It seems like every week it changes. Yeah. I don't know. And at one time, maybe I thought about it, you know what I mean? But I don't anymore.
Is this
really
not that important?
I know. I've been asked a question. You know, everyone asks you that question. What kind of band are you?
Right.
And you know, it's impossible to answer. Though I did find the ultimate answer: classic rock of the future.
Well, there you go.
There's the best answer you could possibly have.
You totally messed up all the record company people. What?
You have a reference in one of your songs to Noel Gallagher. You disagreed with his point of view that rock and roll shouldn't try to say anything.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
So what are you trying to say?
Well, actually, I don't really think anything in particular. I mean, I'm kind of a voyeur in as far as, you know, lyrical content is concerned. The world is such a ridiculous place. There's just so much you can say about it, right? And sometimes being literal is a little too dangerous. Sometimes being literal is a good thing, but sometimes it's, you know, a little too dangerous. For the simple fact that, you know, people, they have no openness to a song. They can interpret it their own way, and that's sometimes better for them to do, because if you can apply anything to your own life, it becomes, you know, tenfold. But I don't remember. I was here. He was sitting outside that window, I remember, and I was watching it on TV, and I was just kind of like, that was just a stupid thing to say. And it's just the chorus of that one song, I don't know where you think you are. I just thought, does this guy wake up in the same place I do?
Right.
Turn on the same television, you know? But
sometimes it's hard, and sometimes it's harder, and sometimes it's all the same. Sometimes it never stays, when I have a second, and she says, love me. She says, my destiny is turning out all wrong.
Matthew Goodband, can you explain what's going on here? Who are your neighbors in the artist compound?
Green Day, I think, is right there.
Great.
And of course, yeah, exactly. And the Watchmen are right there, and Copyright.
It's a nice little neighborhood you got going on here.
Yeah, not a lot of traffic, which is always good.
If there was any awards for the Edge Fest,
mm-hmm.
you got to get the Bravery Award.
I do, yeah. You figure?
Can we explain why?
You figure? Because my leg is bruised from about my knee to my crotch. And I was playing soccer a couple weeks ago, and I tore a muscle in here. And then right before Edge Fest in Toronto, I was kicking the ball around with the Killjoys, and I did it again. And I went on stage, and it was not a fun show to play because it hurt like hell.
I gotta say, one of the videos of the year, I love this one. And it's a great song, and you were telling me, and I didn't even notice it, that there's no actual performance footage.
No.
It's just,
no.
You don't miss it.
No, that video was kind of haphazardly done because we had a completely different idea for it, and we were supposed to go down to Mexico and shoot it, and it kind of fell apart in the stages, and we were really busy, so I ended up talking to Bill Morrison, who directed it, and we kind of came up with the idea in a day, and then shot it the day after that, kind of starting for 2 days. So, and we just really didn't want, you know, we've done two videos where we play the guitars and move around and stuff, and we thought it would just be interesting to do one where no one sings and no one plays anything, and it worked out well.
Say hello,
suicide mystery.
And this is not a project that is easy disposed of for you either.
Oh, no, no. Yeah. So we've been doing it quite a while. We'll probably continue doing it quite a while from now. So it's for me, music is not, you know, just about that whole selling a lot of records. I would continue to do it if five people bought albums, my records. So it's
right on.
On September 24th, Escape to This Place. The 1998 Much Music Video Awards. With performers the Bare Naked Ladies, Smashing Pumpkins, Philosopher Kings, Love Inc., Big Wreck, and Jason Priestley, members of Aqua and the Backstreet Boys. Step out of the world you call home and become the 1998 Much Music Video Awards. Thursday, September 24th, only on Much Music. Brought to you by Nintendo 64.